أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. السلام عليكم dear brothers and sisters. After the martyrdom of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam, Abu Bakr usurped the land of Fadak, which the Prophet gifted to Fatima al-Zahra during his lifetime. When Fatima al-Zahra alayhi salam found out, she went with a group of women to the mosque. She talked to the people of Medina and the Caliph of the time, and this moment in history is commonly known as the Fadakiyya sermon. In the sermon, she defended her rights of Fadak, and she mentioned how the Prophet rescued them from their sinful lives. She then defended the Imam of her time. Those who narrated the sermon of Fadak also described the great hijab of Lady Fatima alayhi salam. First, they said, لاثت خمارها على رأسها. Fatima al-Zahra alayhi salam wrapped the khimar on her head. Khimar here refers to a large and long scarf or veil that covers the head and the chest to the belly. The Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned this word in the Holy Quran in Surah 24, verse 31, وَلِيَضْرِبْنَ بِخُمُورِهِنَّ عَلَى جِيُوبِهِنَّ, and to draw their veils over their chests. It is understood from this verse that before its revelation, women wore their scarf in a way that they put it behind the head so that the neck and a part of the chest was visible. The Holy Quran and Islam urged women to wear their scarf in a way that the neck and breasts was to be veiled and covered. Therefore, Fatima al-Zahra alayhi salam wore the khimar which covered her head and went over her chest. The khimar was not the only hijab of Lady Fatima, peace be upon her. The narrators continued and said, وَإِشْتَمَلَتْ بِجِلْبَابِهَا, and then she wore the jibab, that refers to a more complete coverage. It is like the modern day version of the overhead abaya or chador. Many Fatimi females put it on their head, covering from the head to the feet. This jibab was so long that it covered Lady Fatima's, peace be upon her's, holy feet, meaning they made no noise. The narrators of the sermon also described the hijab of Fatima, peace be upon her, تَطَأُوا ذِيُولِهَا. This means that when Fatima al-Zahra alayhi salam was walking, she would step on her abaya. Let it be known that this was the perfect hijab of Fatima al-Zahra, the hijab of the master of the woman. When she went outside to defend her rights, the believers should know that she did so with great grandeur and dignity. Also, when she entered the mosque, she ordered a Yemeni curtain to be placed over her, which was known for its thickness. And this curtain was placed behind her and the people in the mosque. Therefore, even with her complete hijab, she still didn't address men directly, but rather behind the curtain. So the important question that should be asked is that, can ordinary women be fully Fatimi? Based on the opinion and present times, any believing woman can be Fatimi, but they need the spiritual faith and strength. This is because a veil and abaya doesn't make a female Fatimi. Iman or faith is what makes a female Fatimi. Believing females need a strong faith in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the Ahlul Bayt, peace be upon them, to be Fatimi. But the abaya and veil is always a good start. There are no limits for the fallible person when it comes to the Fatimi hijab, because it is flawless in every way. So we urge every sister to not just stop there. Fatimi hijab in the West is a struggle for any Muslim woman. But as discussed earlier, those who uphold strong faith can overcome any struggle and tribulation. No geographical location should stop the believers from changing and becoming the best Alawis or Fatimis. For example, America has its constitution and the freedom of religion. So to be a good Muslim and having the right to be who you are in the West gives the people an advantage. It is true and undeniable that there is hate and Islamophobia, but there is still freedom. Some unfortunately use their freedom of religion to hate on hijabi women, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the protector of all the believers. Once a female begins her Fatimi path internally, she can slowly develop and become Fatimi externally. A Fatimi woman is never afraid of any hateful comment, she only fears Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. A lot of the Shia women want to wear the Fatimi hijab, but their fear of hateful looks stops them. Inshallah, as lovers of Ahlul Bayt, peace be upon them, we can grow in faith and steer towards the Fatimi hijab. The Fatimi hijab in the West is a banner of Zahra alayhi salam, and one which will fill our Imam with pride and joy. Thank you for watching the video. Please like, share and subscribe. to support the Fatemi movement.